Okay, so I start, yes, so I'm just going to do a little light compression right down the middle. And then when we come to the sacrum, we're just going to place here and lean in so we open up the lower back. One thing is, like, when you're pressing on the top of the shoulders, you know, we get nice relaxation here. But if you turn a little bit and come more at a 45-degree angle, you can get the attachment of levator right above the superior angle of the scapula. So you can lean in and depress right above the superior angle so that you get nice stretch. And I'm just going to take my thumb and just sink in there a little bit. Okay, so we're going to come up on the table. We're going to reach across the spine, and I use the heels of my hands to compress into the musculature just immediately lateral of the spine. And we're going to compress down and slightly away. So take a nice inhale, please, and exhale. This hand can stay stationary, and we're just going to work down. Pressure's okay.
Is that 90 or
jumping?
You couldn't really tell.
What? Like a little elf.
So they take that compression down and onto the sacrum, right? And you want to do that a couple times. Your feet actually are great over there, Lenny, since I wish you were in a pool or something. Kicking.
I can just see, like, the feet going back and forth in the corner of the video.
Compressing on the exhale. Okay, now we want to be a little bit more specific around the scapula. So in this instance, we can take the hand and put it up like this and take our foot and support the arm so it doesn't slip. Now, the vertebral border of the scapula is a little bit more pronounced, but in this position, you can take your thumbs and just lean right in real nice. Pressure's okay?
Mm-hmm.
See how nice that works? Easy. Outside hand and cup the front of the shoulder, and then with the tips of my fingers I'm going to put them right up against the vertebral border of the scapula and we'll mobilize right into it. So my arm is straight, this arm, so I'm just rocking back. Change my acclimation so I can continue following around the scapula. And then I'm going to start here and go straight down, just immediately lateral of the spinous processes, so we're in the lamina groove. We're going to take that all the way down. Start at the top here, sink in, and then just work our way down. Pressure's okay.
Mm-hmm.
Now, a lot of times when people are tight around their spine, you know, you can compress down, but a simple thing to create a little space is to sink in and turn your hand up. Because what it does is it's engaging the tissue, but it's moving the muscle away from the bone a little bit because you're rotating the contact point. So you sink in, neutral hand, and then you turn like this. So you work in and away. Down. To the sacrum. And here, where the top of the iliac crest here, you want to come in. I'm changing arms so I can get in. And what I mean by in is like here's the top of the iliac crest, here's the spine. I'm going right for that juncture where the spine comes down and the iliac crest comes. There's a ligament that comes across from the center to the top of the ilium on both sides, and it helps stabilize the sacrum, but also when it gets tight, it starts to pull a little bit. So we're going to come in at an angle and just to come right up into that juncture. So I'm leaning that way. Just leaning in. Take my thumbs, and I'm going to work this lateral border here of the longissimus. So I'm going to start. So come around if you can't see. So this is basically the same thing we were doing in sideline. I'm addressing that same lateral border of the muscle. So I'm leaning in and just really coming into there, brace thumb. But this time I'm going to follow that whole lateral border all the way up. Because in shiatsu, this is a line, the bladder meridian. It's right into that bladder border. And even in this here, I'm standing like this. I have one foot in front of the other. My arms are extended and my thumbs are braced so I can just lean in. Because in this stance, you can let your weight shift and do the work. If you're here, you're pushing. Here, you're leaning. Then you can just take it right up into the neck. And we'll end with a little mobilization of the shoulder. Right. So, like this. And you would just transition in there, repeat the same thing on the other side. So I'll do one more time for you. Compressing on the exhale. And really let your weight come across. So I can bring it up onto the sacrum. So the pressure is down and away. It's a nice thing to have done to you at the end of the day. Or the beginning of the day or the middle of the day. So compression. And we're going to come over. Bring the arm up and stabilize it. Thumb over thumb. And look how, because of the position of the arm, how I'm able to sink right up underneath that scapula like that. this, so I can use my outside hand to cup the front of the shoulder, and the fingertips of the other hand come right up against the vertebral border of the scapula, and we'll mobilize it right in there. I'm just going to add this, switch hands, and then this is a compression and a twist. So here's the spine here, and I'm just going to go. So I'm compressing and twisting. Around the scapula. This segment really helps free up the scapula in the back, so it's good. Just following the contour of the scapula. And coming from the top, taking it all the way down. Coming in at a 45 degree angle there, right where the sacrum meets the spine. And then working the lateral border, thumb over thumb. So you're starting just immediately, just proximal to the iliac crest. Nice open stance, extended arms leaning in. Leaning in on the exhale. Just to end like we started.